Hello friends, so welcome to the course of power electronics on the Electrical is Easy channel. So this is the 23rd video on the subject power electronics, and I'll just put up a link on the playlist so that you can check the previous videos. So today we are going to discuss a very interesting topic. We'll be starting the topic today and it will take around 3 lectures to complete. So today we are going to start with the topic on the reverse recovery characteristics of a diode. Okay, so when does this reverse recovery characteristic become important in selection of a diode? In fact, many of the terms which come under the reverse recovery characteristics are very important parameters in selection of a diode. Okay, that's why these characteristics are very important. So when did this characteristic become important? So basically, the idea of a reverse recovery characteristics comes when a forward bias diode is suddenly subjected to a reverse bias condition. Okay, so let me explain. For example, you are having a voltage source like this. So this is your voltage source V, and you are having a diode which is connected. Let us call this diode as D, and this current through the diode is called ID. Let this be connected to a load resistor R here like this. Okay, so this is the basic circuit that we are having. So usually what do? We call a forward bias condition, we show a reverse bias condition, we show an unbiased condition. But here what is going to happen is that you are subjecting, that is the voltage V is positive initially. Okay, so the diode will be forward bias. But suddenly at a time period, say T naught, you are going to subject the diode to a reverse bias condition. Okay, so that is the basic idea here. So suddenly at this point, let us call this point as T0. So initially let us call this voltage as plus V1, and suddenly at a point T0, you are subjecting the diode to a reverse voltage of, let us call it as minus Vr. So how does this diode behave? So that is what the entire concept of reverse recovery characteristic lies on. So we'll just write that down here. So when a diode is reverse biased, or we can call it is subject to a reverse bias, when it is under forward conducting. Okay, so to understand the concepts of reverse recovery characteristics, whatever we have learned till now, you should understand. So we'll do a small recap for that. So we'll see what was the conditions happening in the diode when it was the forward bias condition, unbiased condition, and the reverse bias condition. Okay, so in the forward bias condition, let us see what was the condition of the depletion layer. Okay, depletion layer. Okay, I will not be explaining it in depth. For that, you can watch the previous videos. So the depletion layer, or we can call the depletion width, is reduced to phi naught minus phi. Right. In the forward bias condition, the depletion layer or depletion width was reduced to phi naught minus phi, where phi naught was the depletion layer width in the unbiased condition. Okay, so phi naught was the depletion width in the unbiased condition. Okay, in the unbiased condition. Okay, and then the second condition is that what we saw, the large amount of majority carriers from the p-type material will cross the junction and move to the n-type material because of this reduced depletion width. So that is what we have seen. So the large amount of holes, or the majority carriers in the p-side junction, move to the n side, okay, and recombine with the electrons, and thereby you are having the diffusion current that we have already seen. So we'll just show that in the diagram here. So in this case, I have told you the depletion width is very, very narrow, right? So the depletion width is very, very narrow, and this width we told it was phi naught minus phi. And for example, this is the value of the number of holes, okay, in the p side. So we called it as pp. And here I told you, because of the reduced depletion width, a large amount of majority carriers from the P side will move to the N side. So this we have already seen. So that value we are showing it like this. So this will be that value. And this value we called it as PP dash. And gradually there will be recombining, that value will reduce, and finally it will come to an equilibrium value like this. Okay, so this we have seen here. Now the next condition was the diode in the unbiased condition. In the unbiased condition, what you are applying? You are applying no voltage across the diode. Okay. So in that case, what was the depletion width? In that case, we will just draw it a little bit bigger here. In that case, the depletion width was 5 nanometer. Okay, right. In this case, the depletion width was 5 nanometer. And here you are having like this number of holes in the majority carriers in the P side and number of minority carriers in the N side, which is the holes. So that was the thing here. So here, what were the conditions? The depletion width value is 5 nanometer. So this is one condition. And what happened here? You have an equilibrium when the drift current equals to the diffusion current. The drift current equals the diffusion current. So this also we have seen in the previous videos. And finally, we saw diode in the reverse bias condition. So in the reverse bias condition, I told you the depletion layer increases, right? So the depletion width increases. So the depletion width increases to 5 nanometer plus 5, right? 5 nanometer plus 5. So there are only less number of holes which can move from the P side to the N side. Okay. So here we'll show a larger depletion width here. So this is the increased depletion width, 5 nanometer plus 5. Okay, and here you can draw the P side charge, so you can call it as PP, and this value will be very less. In the previous, for the forward bias condition, you see that value is very high. In this case, only a few amount of holes are going to travel to this side, so that value will be very less. That is the number of minority carriers in the N side. Okay, so this is PP dash, PP star. This also will gradually come to an equilibrium value. And this also we have seen in the previous videos. Okay. Now, when does this reverse recovery happen? See, your diode is conducting in this stage. This is the forward conduction mode, right? The diode is conducting in this stage. Now, what you do, suddenly from this stage, you are applying a reverse voltage and you are expecting the characteristic will become like this. That is what is the basic idea of the reverse recovery characteristic. So, the characteristics moves from, or the depletion width has to move from 5 nanometer minus 5 to 5 nanometer plus 5. Now this cannot happen instantaneously. That is why this name reverse recovery characteristics comes. Okay. So I have already told you the basic idea here is that you are having a circuit here like this. Okay. And this is your applied voltage V. And the voltage that you are going to apply is something like this. Okay. So initially you are having a plus voltage V1. Then at time t0, you are applying a voltage of minus Vb. So initially the diode is happily conducting. This positive voltage is applied, the diode is happily conducting. Suddenly you are applying a reverse voltage. So what will happen? That is what we have to see. Now, in the forward bias condition, see the depletion width was 5 nanometer minus 5. Right? And in the reverse bias condition, the depletion width is 5 nanometer plus 5. So when it is moving from forward bias to the reverse bias condition, what should happen? It will move from the depletion width, okay, actually it will be 5 nanometer minus 5, less value. From here it will become 5 nanometer, right, in the unbiased condition, and then it will become 5 nanometer plus 5. So what is happening in this time period is what we have to analyze. Now before making things a little bit complicated, we have to see how an ideal diode behaves in the same condition. Then we will see the actual characteristics, that of a practical diode. Once you understand the ideal diode characteristics, it is very easy to understand for a practical diode. So in this video, we will just see what happens to an ideal diode condition. Okay. Now in an ideal diode, you know that there is no voltage needed to overcome. So you remember the diode characteristics, right? So in a practical diode, you know that the characteristic is something like this. Only after a particular voltage, that is called as V gamma, is that the current increase. But in an ideal diode, you know that this is the characteristic, right? If this is the diode voltage Vd, you know the characteristic is like there is zero voltage drop across the diode. So that is one condition that you have to remember here. So let us see what is the characteristics for an ideal diode. What is the reverse characteristics of the ideal diode? That is what we are going to see. So again, the circuit is simple. So this is the voltage V, and here you are having a diode D, and here you are having a resistor R. Okay, now in the forward bias condition, this current will be ID. That is called this current as ID. Okay, now let us draw a few graphs. So drawing graphs is very important in power electronics, and drawing graphs neatly will help you in understanding the subject in a much better fashion. Okay, so let us first draw the applied voltage characteristics. Okay, so whatever we are applying here, that is V value, we will draw initially. So we will mark a time period T0. We will mark a time T0 here. The time axis, this is T0, this is T0, this is T0. This is time axis, this is time axis, and this is also time axis. Okay, so first we will draw the characteristics of V. So characteristic of V. So what did I tell you? You are applying a voltage V. You are applying a voltage of plus V1. Suddenly at time T0, you are changing the voltage to minus V. Okay, so that's the basic thing. You are applying a reverse voltage. So here you are applying a reverse voltage at time T is equal to T0. Okay, so this voltage value is minus V. So this characteristic is of the applied voltage. Okay, next we will draw the characteristic of the voltage across the diode for an ideal case. Voltage across the diode for an ideal case. Now, whatever voltage you are applying V1 here, there is no drop across the diode. Why? Because it is an ideal diode. There is no drop across this particular voltage. In your analog electronics course, you might have learned about this particular model. A diode can be represented as a voltage source in series with a resistance. Right? Something like this. Okay? And this voltage is called voltage across the diode. That is, the voltage across V gamma and RD is usually called the diode voltage. Okay, so what we are telling is that the value of VD we have to plot now. So in an ideal case, when the diode is forward conducting, this VD will be equal to 0. So in this case, you see the VD value, we are applying a voltage V1, at that time the VD value will be equal to 0. So that we will draw. So till point T0, the VD value is equal to 0, because it's an ideal mode diode. In a practical diode, it will be a different value. But for an ideal diode, this is the case. Now, when you apply a reverse voltage, this diode will be an open circuit. Right? This diode will be an open circuit. Now, if you use a KVL, you will clearly get this VD will be equal to this minus VV, or the reverse voltage. This VD will be equal to this reverse voltage. This is like an open circuit, right? You apply a simple KVL, you will find that this value will be this reverse voltage value. Okay. So this here it is 0 volt. Okay, the diode voltage is 0, and here it is minus V. Here it is minus V. Now the third characteristic is important, is this ID value. That is the diode current. ID is what? ID is the diode current. ID is the diode current. Okay. Now when the diode is forward conducting, this diode is like a short circuit, right? When the diode is forward conducting, what will be ID value? Simple Ohm's law. This is not dropping any voltage, so the voltage will be applied across the R value. So it will be V divided by R. Now in the forward conducting mode, what is the value of V? That is still T0, what is the value of V? V1. So that will be V1 divided by R. So ID will be equal to V1 divided by R till it is T0. Okay. So we will just draw that value. So ID, this third characteristic is for ID. So ID will be equal to V1 divided by R. So this value will be equal to V1 divided by R. Why? Because the diode is a short circuit, right? So this V will come across the R. The value of V is equal to V1. Now, when you apply the reverse voltage, the diode is like an open circuit, right? So what will be the ID value? It will be equal to 0, right? But in a practical diode, I already told you, there will be a reverse current which is flowing, reverse saturation current. But in an ideal case, this applied voltage, this reverse voltage will make the diode non-conducting, or it is like an open circuit. So what will be the ID value after T0? It will be equal to 0. It will be equal to 0. So here ID value is equal to 0. Okay. So I'll just write down that. So for T less than T0, ID value is equal to V1 divided by R. For T greater than T0, ID value will be equal to 0. Why? Here diode is like a short circuit, and here diode is like an open circuit. Okay, so this is the characteristics of the ideal diode when you are applying a voltage like this. That is from plus V1 to minus VB at time t is equal to t0. In the next video, we will see the same graphs for a practical diode. Okay, so that is the important part. But till now, you should understand things very properly. Okay, so if you have not watched the previous videos, please go and watch them so that it will help you in understanding the next topic. So till I see you in the next video, it's me Varun signing off and have a great day. Thank you.
Now that the video is over, please stay with me for 30 more seconds. Now the vision of this channel is to create a repository of good quality videos with crystal clear explanation regarding various topics related to electrical engineering. Now if you want to help me spread the word, please share this video with anyone interested in these topics. The second thing is that for me, education is a two-way process. Therefore, if you have any doubts or suggestions regarding any of the videos or regarding the channel, please put them in the comments below. We can have a healthy discussion, and that way we can build a strong community of electrical engineers. So that's it for today's video. So till I see you in the next time, it's me Varun signing off, and have a great day. Thank you.